Hello, this is Marine for Lan Fan, and I'm excited to be back with a shutter card showcasing some lovely scrolls celebrating Christmas. Those cuties are from Let's Go Nuts, a brand new stamp set. Originally, they're supposed to go with the fall theme, but I thought it would be fun to take them to a winter wonderland. So I started by stamping most of the images from Let's Go Nuts and also some other images from different sets, including a whole bunch of trees to help me create a forest inside the card. Like always, you will find all the supplies listed below the video. So everything was stamped using jet black ink and colored using alcohol markers. When the coloring was done, I created a house for my little characters using another new product, the Acorn House die set. I started with the main piece that I colored using frayed burlap and vintage photo oxide inks. The top of the acorn was cut out of chocolate bar cardstock and I used Grand Espresso Distress Ink to bring more depth to it. The door and the window were cut out of paper bag cardstock, and I used walnut stain distressing to make them less flat. For the doorstep, I used narwhal cardstock with a touch of hickory smoke distressing. And the last elements, these are from Build a House Christmas add-on. I cut the cable piece out of narwhal cardstock and the string of light out of white cardstock, and I used pink and red markers to color the lights. Before assembling the house, I glued small pieces of vellum at the back of the door and window, and then I finally attached everything to build the acorn house. Next, I moved on to the shutter card. Very easy to build using the shutter card die set and add-on. I started by cutting a card base, two shutters and one centerpiece out of Strathmore Bristol cardstock. And to create a winter landscape on my panel, I used a hill stencil. I placed it right below the marks that the die creates and used sponge sugar to create the sky. Next, I added one lipstick distressing from the top towards the bottom and blended the colors together. For the bottom of my card, I wanted to create snow, so I placed the same stencil over the pink sky and used hickory smoke to create some snowy hills. And I applied the ink with a light hand to keep the whole background very light. Next, I put the centerpiece in the middle of my shutter panel and placed the stencil on top, trying to match with the other hills. And I used sponge sugar and one lipstick distressings again to create a coordinated sky on that centerpiece. And of course, I did the snowy hills as well using the same stencil along with hickory smoke distressing. And I also needed the shutters to match with the other pieces, so I used the same inks again on those elements. Next, I did what I always do, I added lots of texture, starting with some water drops all over the panel. I dried the water using a paper towel, and next I smooshed my one lipsticking pad onto my glass surface. I added water to the ink and splattered drops on my paper on the sky section. For the snowy hills, I mixed some hickory smoke distress ink with water and splatter drops as well on the bottom of my shutter panel. And the last step, I made my panel super sparkly using liquid stardust. Next, I assembled the shutter card and I started by folding the sides in. I used my bone folder to get a nice crease, and I also folded the small tabs in. I took the shutters and folded the tabs as well. Now here you can notice that the die has created marks on the paper. Those marks are guides to help you place the shutters at the right spot. So I took the left shutter, removed the backing paper, placed it right up against the left panel between the marks, and I folded that left panel to stick the shutter to it. And I did the same thing with the right shutter. Remove the backing paper, placed it between the marks right up against the right panel, and folded the panel to attach the shutter to it. Next, I noticed that the double-sided tape I had put on the tabs was not on the right side, so I fixed my mistake and applied tape at the back of the tabs. I removed the backing paper of the top tab. I lined up the center piece with the bottom tab and pressed down at the top to stick the center piece to the tab. Next, I removed the backing paper of the bottom tab and attached the bottom of the center piece to finally complete my shutter card. Next, I finally attached the images. And you can notice that I created another panel for the front of my card. This panel was cut using the largest die from the large stitched 4-bar rectangle die set, and I used the same inks and created the same textures as before on that panel. And I used a combination of liquid glue, glue dots, and foam squares to stick everything. At that point, I needed to add some details before attaching the remaining images. I added some shine to the lights using glossy accents. Next, I set the panel aside to let it dry and stuck the rest of the images. Thank you. To stamp my sentiment easily, I flatten my shutter panel in my Misty tool and use the jet black ink to stamp Merry Christmas. That sentiment is from Offset Sayings Christmas. Next step was to stick the front panel. I applied super sticky tape on the left flap of the shutter panel and stuck my front panel to that flap. I still had two white sections that I needed to cover to make the card prettier. And to close the card easily, I started by attaching a piece of twine on the right flap using a small piece of tape. I applied the same tape on that white section and used a paper from the new Let It Shine paper pack to cover that section. I trimmed off the paper and next I did the same thing on the other white section using the same twine and paper. Next, I decided to get messy and to add chunky glitter on some parts of the scene. I first applied liquid glue where I wanted to add glitter, and then I sprinkled chunky glitter on those spots. And I didn't record it because the video was already pretty long, but I added glitter on the inside of the card as well. And that's it, the card is done, and it's super cute with those lovely scrolls and so sparkly with all that chunky glitter. And I'm sure I'm going to find glitter on my desk for a few days. I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I loved making this card. Thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Bye!